to integralcalc.com. We're doing another infinite series problem today. This one is the following. We have 3/2 minus 3/4 plus 3/8 minus 3/16 plus dot dot dot. So this is the series that they gave us, and they've asked us to determine whether or not the series converges. And if it does converge, to find the sum of the series. So, given those instructions, for almost all infinite series problems, the formula that we use is the following three-part formula. I'm going to write down each of the three parts. The first part is x to the k, infinity, absolute value of x less than 1, and 1 over 1 minus x. So I hope you guys can see that. So this formula, this is the first part, second part, the third part. The first part means the sum of the infinite series. We know it's infinite because we have infinity up here. Of the series that takes the form x to the k, where the first value of k, the first value of k in the series is 0, and the series goes on to infinity. If the series takes that form, then we can apply these two. This being, if the absolute value of x is less than 1, then the series converges. If the absolute value of x is greater than or equal to 1, then the series diverges and we can finish the problem. If the series diverges, we can't find the sum of the series, it's indeterminate, so we're done, we should just write diverges. But if it does converge, meaning if the absolute value of x is less than 1 and the series converges, then we use the formula 1 over 1 minus x to find the sum of the series or the value that the series converges to. And of course these three x's are the same x, the same value. So the first thing we need to do is figure out whether or not our series can be written in this form, and if it can, we need to find out what x is, because we need x to plug it into these two parts of the formula to finish the problem. So, the first thing that we do to figure out whether or not our series takes this form here is when we're given a series like this and it's written out, we've got fractions, the first thing we want to do is to factor out the first term in the series. It's the simplest way of going about it. So we're going to factor out 3/2. So if we factor out 3/2, of course the first term then is 1, right? 3/2 times 1 is 3/2. So then we would have minus 1 over 2, right? Because 3 times 1 is 3, and 2 times 2 is 4. Then we'd have plus 1 over 4. And then we'd have minus 1 over 8 plus dot dot dot. Okay, so we factor out the first term in the series. The reason we want to do that is because above anything else, what we want to do is make sure that our series begins with 1, that the first term in our series is 1. So we took out the 3/2 so we could get it to start with 1. So we're already in good shape. What we need to do though now is we need to determine if this series here, starting with 1, going on into infinity, is in the same form as this series. So what I like to do is write this series out so that we can see it. So this series, right, would start with x to the 0 because the first value of k in the series is 0. So we put in 0 for k first. Then since it goes on to infinity, we say plus x to the 1 plus x to the 2 plus x to the 3 plus dot dot dot, right? This is this series written out, expanded. This is the abbreviation, the condensed version, the representation of this series. So this series, if we now simplify it, right, anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So we have 1 here. And then x to the 1 we can just write as x. So then we have plus x squared plus x cubed plus dot, dot, dot. So, you can see, when we've simplified this series, right, the reason that I wanted to factor out the three halves so that the series would begin with one is because this series begins with one. When we expand the series and we write it out and we simplify it, this series begins with one. So if both of our series begin with one, then we're closer to having them match up and figuring out what x is. So now you can see, I'm going to go ahead and erase this because we don't need this line here. Now you can see that we've expanded this series, right? Both of the series begin with one. Remember, the whole goal of going through this exercise is to figure out what x is so that we can then apply it to these two parts of the formula, right? If our series both begin with one like this, here's our x here, right? It's the second term. So I'm guessing that our x is going to be this negative 1/2 here. You always have to include the sign here, otherwise it won't work. So if it's a positive sign, not so much of a big deal, it's just 1/2. But if that's a negative sign, then x is negative 1/2, because if you plugged in negative 1/2 here, right, you get a negative. So, and this is pretty much a dead giveaway. Once you get your series into this form where it starts with 1, almost all of the time, you can guess that the second term, the one immediately following the 1 here, is your x, because this is the expanded series, and chances are they're going to match. X is the second term, and your second term is negative 1/2. So we can almost bet that our x is negative 1/2. But let's just plug negative 1/2 into this series to make sure that it's going to match up with this series here. So if we plug negative 1/2, and you know what, we actually need to, well, we can do it this way. If we plug negative 1/2 into our series, right, we get 1 plus negative 1/2 plus negative 1/2 squared plus negative 1/2 cubed plus dot, dot, dot. Okay? So, that's our series. We can just go ahead and erase this stuff. So let's go ahead and now simplify this, right? We'll get 1, and then we have plus a negative, so we get minus 1/2. And then we have a negative 1/2 squared, which is a positive. We have a negative times a negative, which is positive. Positive 1/4, so plus 1/4. And then negative 1/2 cubed. A negative sign cubed is still a negative sign. And we have 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8 on the bottom, so we have minus 1/8. And then plus dot, dot, dot. So you can see, look, our series, this one and this one, are identical. They do match, which means that we've just confirmed that negative 1/2 is our value for x. We guessed that it was because it was the first term after the 1, which is almost always a dead giveaway. You should guess that and make sure to include the punctuation or the sign here. And we confirmed it because we plugged that negative 1/2 back into our expanded series here, and we see that they match, so we know that we're right, and negative 1/2 is our x value. So that, we went through all of that just to find out what x is. We know that our series takes this form because we got the 2 to match up, and we know that our x is negative 1/2. So now, remember, we had that 3 halves out in front where our series started with 1 and then went on. That was the representation of this series here, but we had that 3 halves out in front, and we can't just forget about that. We have to keep it, otherwise our answer won't come out right. So the way that we write our series now is negative 1/2 to the k. So we said that our x was negative 1/2, so we go ahead and plug it in here, but we have to have that 3 halves out in front multiplied by this whole series. So this would be the abbreviated version, or the condensed version of our whole series here. This is how you would write it in summation notation with the three halves out in front and then the negative one half plugged in for x. So now that we have our series condensed into this form, we can go ahead and take our x, which is negative one half, and plug it into these two components to see whether or not the series converges, and if it does, what the sum of the series is. So let's go ahead and put negative one half into our absolute value brackets over there for our convergence test, right? Absolute value turns this into one half. Absolute value just basically means whatever signs inside of this make it a positive. So since this is negative one half, the absolute value is one half. The absolute value of negative 11 would be positive 11. The absolute value of negative 1.375 would be positive 1.375, so you just take away the negative sign. So we've got positive 1 half. Is that less than 1? Of course it is. So since it's less than 1, the series does converge. Converges to. The series does converge. If this had been greater than or equal to 1, the series would diverge, and we would just write diverges and be done. But since it's less than 1, that means it does converge, and since it converges, that means we now have to take the problem one step further and use this part here to find the sum of the series. So again, we plug in negative 1 half for x, we get 1 minus negative 1 half there for x. And then we can just go ahead and simplify this. We get 1 over 1 plus 1 half because we have minus a negative, so we make that a positive. Let's go ahead and make this 1 here. We can write that as 2 over 2, right? 2 over 2 is the same thing as 1. I'm making it 2 over 2 so that I can combine these two fractions here that now have a common denominator. So I have 1 over 2 plus 1 is 3, and the common denominator of 2. And now I have 1 over 3 halves, which is the same thing as 1 times the inverse of this fraction, which is 2 thirds. And so we've got 1 times 2 thirds, which is just 2 thirds. But remember, we have this 3 halves out in front here. So when we plug in the negative 1 half to this formula here, that's not our final answer. We still have to multiply by this 3 halves here. And what you should actually do is put that out in front at the beginning, put that 3 halves out in front there at the beginning and go through, bring it through all of these steps instead of just adding it to the end so that you don't forget. But we have to multiply this by 3 halves. So you can see we have 3 over 3 and 2 over 2, which is just going to, we can write it out, right? It's just 6 over 6, so the 3's cancel, the 2's cancel, and this just simplifies to 1. So the series converges to 1, or the sum of the series is equal to 1, same thing. But that is how we determine the sum of the series. So you can see our series, which can also be written in this form here, in summation notation like this, this series converges, based on the convergence test, to the value of 1, which we got from this part of the formula here. So that's our final answer, guys. I'll see you next time.